it's Charisma Mom. So I'm kind of doing, like, I got some of my makeup on. I got some more that I kind of want to do, blend some stuff out. But as I did that, I wanted to kind of do like a get ready with me and kind of chit chat. And kind of talk about some of the things that we as women do that as a woman drives me nuts. Just drives me insane. One, the number one thing is putting our baggage onto our significant other. It's very unfair. It's so unfair to do that. It's unfair for him to do that to you as well, but I'm not talking about him. I mean, there's enough guy channels out there and there's enough things out there to say to the guys, you know, hey, pause on this, but some woman to woman. We have to stop because you're wrecking your own relationships. And or you're staying in relationships that you probably shouldn't be staying in because you are seeing these red flags and you're choosing to ignore these red flags for the comfort of a guy, the comfort of being with someone, the comfort of sex. I mean, let's face it, sometimes that's the only reason why people are in relationships. But we're not necessarily in it for the right reasons, for the comfort of having time to share with another human being, growing with another human being, cultivating that relationship. A lot of times that's not there. And if you can't have trust with that person, you do need to kind of do some self-checking and say, you know, are these trust issues, are they mine? Or is he really being untrustworthy? And if it's you, go get help. There's a lot of women groups out there. There's your girlfriend, your mom, anybody, you know, but don't go to the person who kind of has the same thoughts as you. You need to go to that friend of yours that is that friend that's going to tell you exactly how it is. The one that kind of pisses you off and hurts your feelings sometimes because you're like, I didn't like what she said. That's the friend you need to talk to. That's the female that you need to go to. Even if she's kind of had her own messed up relationships, they tend to be the ones that have the best advice. May they not always follow that advice, but they do tend to have the best advice. And so I recommend that you go do that. So my makeup was kind of went, I know we're going to go off a little side note, but I did not mean to have this much makeup on today at all. I'm just running to the grocery store. And I normally just wear eyeliner and mascara. Back to the thing. But if you have issues before you get in a relationship, do not take that stuff into the relationship. Don't take that baggage in and put that on that man, especially if you are coming from an abusive relationship. Don't do that. That's unfair to that man because you are going to A, get back into another abusive relationship or unhealthy, and or B, you're going to have a good guy, but you're going to run him off because of your insecurities and your issues that you have that you didn't take care of from back then. And so that one falls on you. You know, you need to take care of yourself. Now, here's another thing that I see women doing. And when I was a younger woman, I myself was at fault of this. I did this. Oh God, I was in a relationship where literally the guy literally told me, we were at dinner one night and we were talking about just relationships and he says, well, what if you're with someone and you've tried to tell him that, you know, you don't really ever want to be in a relationship with them, that you don't ever seeing the relationship going any further than what it currently is, you know, what do you do? And I just blew right through it. Didn't understand that the person was talking about me. Or if I did at that time, I didn't pay attention at all. And yeah, I ended up staying with the guy for like a year. And finally, after a year, you know, it was kind of just this horrible relationship. It wasn't abusive or anything, but it just was horrible. And at the end of the year, about the third time he had cheated on me, because of course, you know, I was too young to understand that, you know, yes, even if you're maybe not in a serious relationship with someone, like you're not living together and stuff, that if you've had conversations that you're in a monogamous relationship, then that's what you should be in, is a monogamous relationship. But if you've talked to each other and that person says, look, you know, I'm not ready to settle down, I am going to be seeing other people, that's a different story. That's where you choose to whether stay in that relationship or not. I thought that's the type of relationship I was in, but you know, third or fourth time after him cheating, I finally just, you know, I asked him, I was like, you know, what's wrong with me? You know, why are you doing this? And he said, flat out, he said, I told you in the beginning, I didn't really want a relationship with you. He was like, but you're really fun to hang out with. He was like, you know, you're hot. 'Cause when I was younger, I was kind of cute. I just remember thinking that, like, wow, really? How shallow can you be? But he told me in the very beginning that he was not into me and not in the way that I was into him. And I didn't care. I was like, I'm okay. We're just going through this and you're gonna like me, darn it. So yeah, if you are that female and you're having these relationships and they're not working out for you, you're constantly finding yourself hurt and you're constantly finding yourself wondering, get out of the relationship. A, it's not that it might not be the relationship for you. It just may not be the time for you and that person to be together. You as a woman, as a female, you need to heal. You need to take care of your business and what you have going on. Come here. Oh, hot mess. Sleepy baby. Oh, Momo's downstairs. You wanna go downstairs with her? You wanna sit here with me? But that's what we have to do. And if you're not sure, you need to talk to that one friend that pisses you off. And I mean this, I mean that friend who, you know, kind of tells you how it is, even if you don't like it, even if she kind of has her own messed up relationships. And no, you cannot have that. No, you can have this, you can have that, and you can have that, but you can't have anything else. Sorry, parenting moment. But yeah, so that's the friend you want to talk to. Even if, again, like even if she doesn't always have the best relationships, or you think she goes through too many guys, or blah, 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 that's your side chick. That, or not your side chick, that's your ride or die chick. Not side chick, side chick's something else, but your ride or die chick. She's the one that's going to tell you the truth. She's the one that's going to assess the guy and be honest with you and tell you, you know, hey, this guy's a jerk, you need to move on. And don't be mad at her. Listen to her, because at the end of the day, hopefully if your friend's like that, hopefully she has your best interest in mind and she's not coming from a place of vindictiveness or jealousness or something like that. You know, she truly cares about you and she's in the background wanting to take you and shake you till your teeth rattle in your head or smack you across the face and say, snap out of it. That's the female friend that you need. That and that's the one that you want to possibly be, you know, the confidant, you know, have that person that you talk to and kind of say where you're at in your relationship and how you're feeling about your relationship. If you are in a relationship and there are a lot of red flags, I don't care how comfortable it is, I don't care how great the sex is, get out. Because now you're putting yourself in a position to be abused. And I don't mean to be like downplaying, and not every guy's an abuser, but I'm saying you're putting him in a position of power that as a guy, he's gonna play into it. And it's not even that he's trying to be mean or misogynist or anything like that. It's you have now relinquished your power as a female and said, I obviously can't think for myself. I obviously have no respect for myself. So by all means, please allow me to be your doorstep. You can't be mad at him when you become his doorstep. If he's sleeping with you and he's not wanting to marry you because you're not really demanding it, whose fault is that? It's not his fault. You're the one that's doing the business. If you're living with him and you're cooking and you're cleaning and you're doing all the things that as a wife would do, and he's telling you, okay, we're committed up to this point, but we're not committed past this point, girl, get out. go somewhere else. And I'm saying this because I wish someone would have told me this to my younger self many years ago. Would have saved me years and years of strife of trying to make a relationship work with someone that number one, didn't deserve me. Did not deserve me on any level and didn't deserve the effort and the time and the love and the passion that I was putting into a relationship that A, the person didn't want to begin with. They weren't ready for it because they had their own baggage, but I wasn't the one. I wasn't that girl for them, but I wanted to be that girl for them. So I kept pushing and pushing and pushing. And in turn, the relationship became very, very abusive. The relationship became very toxic. And it happens, ladies, it happens a lot. So I'm not saying that we are the reason why we're being abused. Please, please don't think that that's what I'm saying. I'm saying that we cause a lot of our own problems because we don't listen to that little voice inside our head. We get mad at our female friends who are trying to protect us. She's just being a bitch, or she's just jealous. Maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe she's honestly being the first one that's telling you, hey, this might not be the best relationship for you. So anyway, kind of on a rant, but ladies, seriously, if you are not in a healthy place in your head, you have no business getting into a relationship with someone until you've got your stuff together. Because all you're going to do is wreak havoc in his life, wreak havoc in your life, and you could be destroying a potentially really great, amazing relationship. Or you could be destroying yourself even more because you're back in a damn nasty ass relationship that you were so damaged from the first one that the little bit of good that you're getting from this one, you're like, oh, okay, these breadcrumbs are okay. That's all I'm getting. That's all I deserve is breadcrumbs. You don't deserve breadcrumbs. You do deserve to be put up on a pedestal. You do deserve that love. You do demand respect for yourself, but you have to demand it. You have to have it here first. You have to respect you first. You have to love you first. And if you can't do that, he can't do that. All right, so a little bit of ranting, a little bit of passion. I'm gonna talk some little bit more about this, but I just feel like there's a lot of young ladies out there that are hurting and are in relationships that they really should not be in. And they're misguided. They're misguided on what love is. And it could be, you know, maybe they had a bad father figure, but I'm not gonna blame the dads because I'm telling you, I had an amazing, amazing father. And I still put myself in crappy relationships. Maybe you don't know how to dialogue with someone. So I want to be that big sister. I want to be that mom to you that says, girl, cut it out. All right. So I love you guys. God bless. And hope you like the content. And give it a big thumbs up if you do. Hit that subscribe button. And thanks for getting ready with me. All right. We'll talk to you later. God bless.